Well, I hope each week that you wait with anticipation to see what is inside the Holy Mystery Box. Doesn't sound as though there's anything inside the Holy Mystery Box. I wonder, have I forgotten this week to put something inside it? No, I think there's something there. So let's take the lid off the Holy Mystery Box and let's see what is inside. Well, inside our Holy Mystery Box today, well, it's a very light package. That's why it didn't sound as though there was very much inside. But as always, if we look at the packaging, it gives us a clue what's inside. And then that, as always, can help us learn something about God, about our faith, about what God teaches. So when we look at this, it says that it is a package that has 20 foam faces inside. So let's open the package and let's have a little look to see what these foam faces are like. For anybody who likes arts and crafts, you must love buying these kind of things. I'm not really so good at drawing or arts and crafts, but if you are, you probably could take some of these faces. And there is a blue one, and there is a red one, and there is a yellow one, and there is a green one. I'll try not to drop them on the floor. There is a green one. So maybe we'll put the rest in the Holy Mystery Box. But there is all these colors of faces. What would you draw on your face? You'd probably draw a couple of eyes. You might draw a nose. Would you draw some hair up here? You might draw a smiley face or a sad face. Actually, it might be a good way of saying how we are each day. If we put a smiley face, we're happy. If we put a sad face, maybe not so happy. But like I say, if you're good at crafts, you would know what to do. I should have brought some pens along with me and drawn some faces on them, shouldn't I? But what do we learn today from this packet of faces? What do we learn about God? Well, when I was thinking about this talk, the thing that struck me was that each face by color was different. Each face was different. And yet, each face was the same shape, the same size. And it made me think about the differences in our world and how we think about people that are different from us. I'm sure you notice that everybody is different. Some people look different because the color of their skin is different. Some people look different because they might have a disability, not able to do things that we might be able to do. Some people might be different because they like different things from us. Some people are sporty, some people are not. Some people like reading, some people don't. Some people might be different because they're taller or they're shorter than us. Some people might be different because they are a boy or a girl, male or female. And you know, the beautiful thing about our world is that everybody is different. But sometimes in our world, people treat each other differently because they're different from us. They look at someone who perhaps has a different color of skin and they say, "You're of less value than me," and they say horrible things about them. Or they look at somebody perhaps who has a disability who can't do the things that we might be able to do, and they say, "Well, you're of less value because you can't do this or this or this." Or they look at someone who is different because they like something different, and they make fun and they tease them because they are different. And you know, I would be pretty confident in saying that that makes God very sad. You see, it makes God sad because right at the beginning of the Bible, it tells us that when God creates the world, he creates everybody in his own image. So all of us, even though we might be different, we are made in the image of God. And because we're made in the image of God, we are special to God and we are loved by God. And that's a really important thing that we can learn. Each of these faces represents something that is the same, but something that is different about us. And it's important that we treat everybody the same, everybody equally, no matter what they look like, or no matter what they're able to do, or no matter how they might be different from us, that we treat everybody exactly the same, because that's how God treats us, exactly the same, with the same love and the same way of respect. So I think that's what we learn today, is that we rejoice that everybody is different. That's what makes the world so special. But we challenge ourselves to make sure that we treat everybody exactly the same. And the song that we're going to sing is a lovely song. Let me get the words just to remind me. And it's a song called If I Were a Butterfly. And it reminds us that everyone and everything that God has created is unique. If I was a butterfly, I'd thank you, God, for giving me wings. If I was a robin in a tree, I'd thank you, God, for making me sing. If I was a fish in the sea, I'd waggle my tail and I'd giggle with glee. But this is the important part that we learn. It says, but I just thank you, God, for making me, me. Everybody's special because that's the way God has made us. So let's join in the words of this song together.